We mark more than 200,000 American lives lost and 6 months of the NewsHour honoring the victims of COVID-19 every Friday evening. Tonight, we honor five more. Here are their stories. Howard Croft had no tolerance for injustice. Raised by his grandparents in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, Howard learned early on to fight for working people. He spent decades fighting for social justice and advocating for voting rights and D.C. statehood. His wife described Howard as entirely fierce, but said he let his gentle side show for her and the rest of their family. Howard was 78. Ana Maria de la Torre was an icon in her San Jose neighborhood, her friend said. For dozens of families, she cared for their children as a nanny and cleaned their homes. The Mexican native loved hosting huge parties and bringing people and cultures together. She was known for her phenomenal cooking. Ana was also a fighter. She survived lymphoma in 2012. Her beloved son and granddaughter were by her side when she passed at the age of 65. Growing up in Ford City, Pennsylvania, Timothy Russell enjoyed reading so much that his mom would have to ask the librarian to send him home for dinner. He went on to become an admired scholar, headmaster of Christian schools, and most recently, a minister in Memphis, Tennessee. A friend said that Tim was a courageous pastor who loved fiercely. He enjoyed traveling the world with his wife. Tim was 62 years old. 47-year-old Raven Voice was a born caregiver. Raised in Tulsa, Oklahoma, as a member of the Creek Nation, Raven's daughter said her mom was always taking care of others. She tutored and mentored Native American students and worked for 14 years as a nurse for the elderly. Above all else, her family said, she was dedicated to her mother, children, and grandchildren. Ray Doc Doherty would sit on the front porch of the house he lived in for 49 years in Philadelphia and smile or chat with anyone who walked by. A letter carrier for the U.S. Postal Service for almost four decades, Doc was beloved by the community he served. Doc's wife of 50 years said her U.S. Army veteran husband was a simple man whose greatest joys were her, their three children, and 13 grandchildren. Doc was 70 years old. We want to thank all the family members who shared these stories tonight. Our hearts go out to you and to everyone who's lost a loved one in this pandemic.